This sounds very promising in tonight's MedWatch. A recent trial of the experimental cancer drug Dostarlimab, tumors in all 14 patients with early stage rectal cancer disappeared. Now, while it is a small sample size, researchers are calling it a groundbreaking development in the world of cancer treatment.
A lot of people excited about this one. Dr. Audrey Kam was not part of the study, but there she is. She is a director of gastrointestinal medical oncology at Rush University Medical Center. She's joining us now to talk a little bit more about this. Hello to you.
Thank you.
All right, let's start at the very beginning. What is this drug? Have we seen anything like this before?
Yeah, so dostarlimab is a type of immunotherapy, and it works by unmasking the body's immune system, thereby allowing our own immune cells to recognize and fight the cancer cells.
Two things here. I mean, what was your reaction to learning that all 14 of these trial participants came out cancer-free, which just seems stunning, and then it was a small sample size? What are the implications of that size? Why so small?
So the study results are quite encouraging for our rectal cancer patients. You know, with 100% complete clinical response, patients were able to avoid chemotherapy, radiation, surgery, which can be associated with long-term complications and as well as other risks. However, I do want to point out that the particular trial was targeting a specific patient population. So it enrolled patients with tumors that have what's known as DNA mismatch repair deficiency, and that makes a tumor susceptible to immunotherapy. And the reason why the sample size is likely quite small is that it's only seen in about 5 to 10% of all early stage rectal cancers.
All right, so give me a little bit of perspective. How rare is it to see 100% of the participants, of the patients getting positive results? Like, we don't see that very often.
Yeah, so in oncology trials, regardless of tumor type, it is pretty uncommon to get 100%. But we have to remember that the median follow-up time is quite short, so we're only at 7 months of follow-up. And so long-term, it will be interesting to see if that response rate will be maintained. So we're hoping to get that as well as survival data in the follow-up study.
Well, Dr. Kam, you know, people who are watching this right now, so many of us have been touched by cancer in some way. So this is going to be really exciting. Does this work? Do you foresee it working on other forms of cancer?
So I think we know for tumors, like I said, with DNA mismatch repair deficiency, that immunotherapy has a major role in multiple tumor types. I think for dostarlimab, we will need a larger study with more patients enrolled across multiple institutions and longer follow-up time as well as survival data. So definitely immunotherapy has become more and more promising for all of our patients.
So it seems like this is the first step in many steps to come. But talk to us about the timeline and sort of how long it could take to really see other studies come down the line where we may know more about how effective this is.
So typically, you know, survival data could take up to a year to report out, and larger studies, you know, can take 1 to 2 years to enroll if we're looking at a 5 to 10% incidence of this particular type of, you know, tumor. So it could be, you know, a year or two before we really see, you know, a drug approval as such and going through all the FDA regulations.
Last question here. What has been the reaction in the medical world and around the whole world?
I think we're all very excited. You know, it's always great to see 100% complete clinical response in oncology. But of course, we approach it with caution and we want to see longer term follow-up. And we also want to see if this would hold true with other immunotherapy drugs as well.
Dr. Okay. Audrey Kam with Rush, thanks for sharing this good news with us. We appreciate it.
Thanks for having me.
All right.